when we use our privilege to help others. And there's hope when we take that sadness and turn it into action. And so it's so lovely to see all of you out here every January, but every year I hope we never have to do it again. And so I challenge each and every one of you to think not just about what you'll do today, but about what you'll do tomorrow, and the day after that, and the day after that, until this BS is over. So I know I don't have to tell you that you're gonna vote, right? But are you going to make sure that every person you know votes as well? Yes! Are you going to pull a Catherine Carson and ask every person you see on the street if they're registered to vote? Yes! Are you going to knock on doors with me? Yes! Are you going to donate to candidates and causes that are fighting for the things that you believe in? Yes! And are some of you going to run for office? I sure hope so. It's not that bad, I swear. So today, I ask you to think about why you are here, and then take that why and turn it into what will you do? Thank you.
Kudos to Beth for sticking to our vow that no one would speak for longer than 3 minutes. She got her point across and she did it quickly, and we love her for that. Our second speaker is Leona Thurston. Leona was born and raised in Steamboat. She's a senior at Steamboat Springs High School. Her interests range from 4-H to dance, but today she's here to talk about sexual assault. Specifically, she's here to talk about how we as a community need to learn to support victims and encourage them to come forward. I remember the feeling of his lips on mine. I remember his pale green eyes looking through me, fueled by greed and manipulation. I remember his strong hand on my chest, stopping all momentum I had towards the door. I remember his grip getting tighter and tighter as all hope vanished. I remember feeling helpless. Time slowed down and I became frozen. My name is Leona Thurston. I'm 17 years old and I'm a senior at Steamboat Springs High School. I'm a fairly typical high schooler. I worry about my grades, I have a job, I have a sister, I ski, I dance, and I have been sexually assaulted. Unfortunately, in today's society, being sexually assaulted is just another part of being a teenager. When I was asked to speak here today, I felt as though I wasn't only representing myself, but also the countless number of my peers who have been sexually assaulted. Today, I would like to share some of their stories with you. However, before I do, I would like to thank them for having the courage to share their experiences. Team one. He counted. 3, 2, 1. But I said no, pushing myself further into the corner. He started counting again, yet this time, the moment after he said one, I had no more space to back up into. So I took up as little space as possible and became the rag doll he held for the rest of the day. Team two. I was manipulated and pressured into performing sexual acts that made me feel uncomfortable, and I was afraid of what would happen if I refused. The fear made me numb to the situation, and all I could do was let it happen. Teen three. I told him no. I told him to stop. I kicked. I screamed. I pleaded, let me go. And he didn't listen. Teen four. He told me I was pretty, that everyone did it, and that it would be quick. He physically pushed me. He forced and coerced me to perform sexual acts on him. Then he left. He changed my life in that short time. Not only was I sexually assaulted, but I was forced to relive it every time I saw my assaulter in the school halls. Oh. Teen five. I feared to tell my parents because I couldn't bear watching them cry and saying they were sorry that they hadn't protected me. I feared telling my friends because I didn't want everyone to see me as a victim. I feared that saying it out loud would define me. Silence was my only friend. These are just a few examples of the countless number of teens who have been sexually assaulted in our community. Many of us grew up here. We took our first steps here. We learned right from wrong here. We made our friends here. We built trust here, but we also lost our innocence here. We live in a very tight-knit community, which makes it easy to keep things hidden. But as a community, we need to learn to support victims and stop discouraging them from coming forward. It doesn't matter what she was wearing. It doesn't matter if she was at a party. It doesn't matter if she said he could kiss her. That doesn't give him consent to do more. Consent is not the absence of no, but rather the presence of yes. You are all able to help support victims by helping them. You are all able to help victims come forward by showing your support and not victim blaming. If you're a victim, I encourage you to come forward. Even if you don't officially report it, tell someone you trust, because the moment you start talking about it, it gets easier. Never be ashamed of your story, because it will only inspire others to tell theirs. If you're not a victim, I encourage you to reach out to advocates or a similar organization in order to learn how to support victims. I encourage all of you to take a self-defense class and learn how to protect yourself, because you're all stronger than you believe. I encourage you to stand up for yourself and never doubt yourself. You all have a voice and you all have a story that deserves to be heard. So support yourself and support each other. We are capable of changing the way future generations think of sexual assault. We have the ability to create a culture that turns victims into survivors. We need to stop protecting the accused and instead hold them accountable for their actions. I will leave you with this. The day you speak up is the day you take your power back. Thank you. Woo! Thank you, Leona.
Our next speaker is Therese Bartholomew. Therese is a writer, activist, self-defense instructor. And she's doing a great job coming up that thing.
I'm 52, that is extreme sports to me right there. Speaking of being 52, let me just go ahead and say this. I have a menopausal brain, so I have a piece of paper to look at. And let me say this, Leona, you are courage. If there is anyone here who needs somebody to talk to afterwards, you can definitely find me. I am a survivor, and this little girl is courage. So, I'm here to remind each of you of your power. As women, we have to remind each other sometimes of that. So I'm here to remind you of your power. I'm here to thank you for standing in the cold and the snow because you love other women and because you love yourself. I am here because so many days I would have fallen right back down without women just like you standing strong at my back and by my side. I am here to encourage you, to impassion you, to remind you again that your voice matters. Your voice here, your voice to other women, your voice in this city, in this county, in the state, and in this country. Along with my son, I teach a self-defense class here in Steamboat. And there's this myth in the world of women's self-defense that women are powerless, that we're waiting to be empowered. Ladies, that is just that. It's a myth. Women aren't powerless. We come from a place and a space of power. I was taught from a very young age, probably not unlike some of you, that my value could only be measured by the man who was by my side. For a long time, I believed that. I had been taught that I had no right to be happy or to experience love or to get an education. It was ingrained. You, Therese, are a caregiver, an emotional center, a sacrificer, a yes-sayer. Even when the voice inside your head is screaming no, no, no. You, Therese, are to be nice and to be polite and to be good and to be sweet. You are to be a shock absorber for all of those around you. You are to be that and to do that today and to wake up and do that tomorrow. Your voice should be a whisper. Ladies, I am not gonna lie. It's taken me a few years to claim it, but my voice is no whisper. In self-defense, we talk a lot about leverage. So while I may be smaller physically, though I'll admit I'm getting a little larger every day now at 52, leverage levels the playing field. There's no need to strain against muscle and strength. Fight with leverage. Our voice is leverage. Our presence here is leverage. Our unity is leverage. Together, we are frickin' power. Yeah. So I want you to leave here today and do this. I want you to help another woman find or remember her power. I want you to support her in claiming it or reclaiming it. All that is distinctly the power of being a woman, help her get it back.
Yes. Yes.
Help her find it. And the last thing I'm going to say is, where are all the little people? Where are all the little women? I need to see y'all. Yeah, girl. All right. So all of the young women, this message is directly for you. I don't care how, I see a little bitty one over here, but all of y'all, young women, there's this woman, the great Betty White, who turned 98 yesterday. And one of the memes that I saw that I love so much, I'm going to share with you. Women, or butterflies, are like women. We may look pretty and delicate, but baby, we can fly through a hurricane. Yeah. Let me tell all y'all little girls out there right now, it is hurricane season. Thanks, y'all.
Many thanks, Therese Bartholomew. Part of the entertainment. You get to watch people struggling. Our next speaker will be Lynn Rahman. Lynn was a diplomat and she has turned into a child's rights activist. Her book, Survivors Breaking the Silence on Child Sexual Abuse, is in its third print run and has been nominated for an award. She has spent the last 5 years before moving here 3 years ago in India, working with an Indian Nobel Peace Laureate to bring better things to the survivors of child sexual abuse. Lynn.
Hi everyone, thanks for being here. I have two stories and I'm gonna keep it short because I know it's cold and thank you for coming out. First story. I was 8 years old when my grandfather started sexually abusing me. My mom taught me about good touch and bad touch. But as an 8 year old, I lacked the words to tell her that it was her own dad that was abusing me. So in my experience, you can teach your kids about good and bad touch, but it's not enough, especially when abuse is happening within the family. I'm working on a graphic novel, a comic book, if you will. We hope it's gonna be like a tool to help kids have conversations with their parents. So we're collecting stories of abuse from children in India, in Kenya, in Pakistan. The stories will be in English and translated into Kiswahili, Hindi, and Urdu. And we hope that this will start conversations happening. Come support our work. So my name is Eliani. If you Google me, I'm the only one in the world. My friends will hate me. So it's the same Eliani too on Facebook, Google, Twitter, Instagram. Find me. My second story. So just 2 days ago on Thursday, my boss asked me to help out with a case in Morocco, in Northern Africa. A young girl, still in college, you know, probably Leona's age, she's had sex outside wedlock and she's been found out by her family. They want her to return from the city that she's studying in to her village this coming Monday to marry a man that she does not know. If they force her to marry him, he may find out that she's no longer a virgin and she risks being killed or being put in jail. So we worked that out yesterday to try and find some sources for her for help, for safety. If you want to help, Google Red Dot Foundation. I sit on the board. We help folks from all over the world, in Argentina, in Cameroon, India, Nigeria, Nepal, Malaysia, and South Africa, to create safe places for those who are suffering from sexual assault and violence. We teach people about how to be active bystanders to prevent sexual violence. And we talk about healthy relationships and we talk about consent. So again, Google me, Eliani, or Red Dot Foundation, or just talk to me afterwards. You can volunteer, you can do all kinds of stuff together. We're in this together. Thank you for listening to my stories. Thank you, Lynn. Our final speaker today is Robin Shepherd. Robin is a leadership consultant. She spent 20 years working in Washington in the Senate and the White House, most recently for First Lady Michelle Obama. She's been living in Steamboat for almost 8 years, and she's going to talk about why political participation is necessary to ensure a robust democracy.
Hey everybody, is everybody staying warm? All right, well I'm so excited to be here. I was here at the 2017 March, and I'm seeing a couple signs that reminded me of that day. I was marching next to two women that were probably in their 70s, and I said, why are you marching? And they were so pissed off, and they said, we did this before. We did this in the 60s, I can't believe I have to do it again. They said they didn't want to go back. And I have to say, I don't want to go back. I'm in my 50s, and I've seen so much change. When I talk to young girls and I tell them what I experienced, they can't believe it. So let me tell you a couple stories. So I am a single mother's child. My mom was a stewardess. When she got pregnant with me, she had to quit her job because back in the 60s, you were not allowed to be married. You were not allowed to have kids because you had to be attractive to the men on the plane. That didn't change until there was a civil action suit in the 1970s. Policy changed. Another story. I went to a Catholic elementary school in New York City. I loved playing basketball. I played basketball at recess. I played basketball on the weekends with the boys. I was a total tomboy. But could I join the basketball team? No. Because in the 70s, there wasn't girls' teams in Catholic elementary schools. It wasn't until Title IX that happened in 1972, a Supreme Court decision, that girls could play any sports in high school and in college. And there's lots of people I've asked the last 2 weeks, do they know what Title IX is? There's so many people that don't even know what that is. So any of you, especially you young girls, if you play any sports, you can thank the women that came before you, because we had to have a Supreme Court decision to have equality in sports. Sounds crazy, but it's true. So I came out of politics. I've worked on 4 presidential campaigns, lots of campaigns, and people say, oh, how did you do politics? Politics doesn't matter. Well, it matters to you every single day. I am a grandchild of immigrants. I didn't learn English till kindergarten. I have immigrant children that I adopted from Kazakhstan. And I feel it is my duty as an immigrant to make sure that my vote matters. So I want to tell you 4 things that you can take action. 1, mentioned before, vote. We make it very easy. There's a registration right there. Woo! 2, Oh, about the votes. I don't know if you know the specifics. In this country, we have about 55% of Americans that vote. That means half the country is making decisions for all of us. The last time that we got over 80% was in 1876. So my challenge to you is let's get back to the voting that we had in 1876 and get over 80%. Do you think you can do that? So the next one, mentioned before, I'm gonna say it again, recruit. So I'm gonna challenge you. Do you think you could all recruit 10 new people to vote in the next election? If each of us, I'm looking at all of us, if we could recruit 10 people, we'd have 1,000 new voters. That would make a huge difference. If you don't know, Bernie Sanders won his first mayoral election with 18 votes. Every vote matters. It matters. The third thing that I'd like you to think about is participation. So voting's not enough. You gotta participate. I can't tell you how many school board meetings I've been to, but you need to go to school board meetings, city council meetings, county commissioner meetings, send emails, call your members of Congress, because if they don't know what you care about, then they can't vote accurately for their constituency. So participate, be a part of it. And then the fourth that's really important is support women in leadership positions. We are 51% of the population. Do we have 51% representation in Congress? No. Do we have a woman in the White House? No. Do we have more women governors than we have men governors? No. Do we have more women CEOs or the same amount of women CEOs or 50% women on corporate boards? No. We need to support women so that decisions are made that reflect the population of the United States. So as much as you can, run for office, support women, get more women. So I just remember those four things. Vote, recruit, participate, and support. Woo! We know if we're all together, we cannot be defeated. So are you in? Yes! All right, thank you.
Thank you to Robin, and thank you to all our speakers. Woo! I hope all of you have had a chance to see each other's signs, because I've been standing here reading them, and they're a hoot. You're creative, you're insistent, you're resistant. All of that is good stuff. Thank you so much for turning out today, for standing here in the cold. Steamboat Springs is an amazing place to live, and it's a wonderful thing to see all of you here, active, excited, and ready to take on 2020. Remember two important dates. The first is the first week in March. That's when both the Colorado primary and the Colorado caucuses take place for the Democratic Party. So get yourself registered and get yourself out there. The second date, of course, is that first Tuesday in November. All of you, please vote. I don't care what your politics are, show up. It's important. We have to have a say in what goes on in this country. Thank you for coming. Please vote, take the actions that you see necessary around you. And give your thanks today, please, to all the volunteers who made this happen. It takes time and money, and people showed up. It's just, again, a wonderful thing. A thank you to the Rock County Democrats for providing the insurance for today and for giving us our voter registration. A big thank you to Big Iron Coffee, who's over there with the food and the coffee, donating their proceeds to Advocate. Let me ask you to take your signs and your trash with you when you leave. And thank you once again for coming, for being strong. Vote. Encourage other people to vote. Get out there in November. Thank you.